Hello everyone, this is Powell Ponder on Weather. In this update, we're going to be talking about flash flooding, damaging winds, a tropical disturbance, and an upcoming cool down. So if you do like weather-related content, please subscribe to my channel as I will upload daily updates to keep you ahead of the storm. So let's get right to it. First of all, let's take a look at this meteor that fell on Sunday night around 8:56. Central Standard Time down in parts of the South. So if you lived in San Antonio in and around the Dallas-Fort Worth area, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, this was captured by a Ring doorbell, and this came out of the eastern sky here. And as it a lot of people were reporting, it was, you know, bright orange, and it turned green at times, and it was a flash of light, and even reports of a boom happening as well. So I would love to hear your reports and what you might have experienced if you actually saw this come out of the sky last night down in the South around 8:56. Definitely leave your comments below in the comment section. So let's get right to it. The overall map, I kind of expanded the view this morning so you can take a look at the big picture of what's really happening. There is our Invest 90L that has been outside of the off the southeast coast. That has spreaded some heavy rain in and around the parts of the Jacksonville area. That will continue pushing inland as we go through the week with some heavier rain along the coastal communities here there. But you see these little boundaries up here, one along into the Ohio Valley, but we also have some colder air, even 34 degrees north of Winnipeg. That's going to bring down some cooler air and then even a much reinforcing shot as we get into the early part of next week for the northeastern states. But what stands out is all the rain this morning in and around the Los Angeles area. That is a beautiful sight to see in and around Palm Springs. So that monsoon, it continues to remain active and spreading some welcome rain in those regions. And we also see down here in the tropics, we've got a flare up of activities just south of Jamaica. We also have this little storm out here that's going to be fizzling out by the time it gets to Hawaii. But we also have another feature that's going to be developing over the course of the week in the eastern Pacific. That's actually going to be reinforcing the shot of that monsoonal flow will continue the rains for parts of those regions as well. So let me kind of take you through the overall hazard map this morning. You can definitely see parts of Southern California under those flash flood watches currently right now, even in Nevada. So these are rare sights to see these areas seeing flash flood watches, but that is the culprit of that active monsoon. But away from that, where that ridge is going to be prevalent, man, that's where the dominating heat will take place in parts of Montana. And then a lot of the higher dew points here into South Dakota, Nebraska, especially the southern states here as we get down here in the coastal regions. Yeah, some of those heat advisories are 105 plus today with that heat index with the higher dew points for them. But yeah, if we zoom in into that tropical disturbance, it's a slow mover. And this morning, we've got training thunderstorms dumping 2-inch per hour rainfall rate. So that's some serious flash flooding happening in that neck of the woods. And they've already indicated just southeast of Jacksonville, 2 to 4 inches, because the cell is nearly stationary. And that's what we're going to be dealing with, this little pesky low pressure. It's not going to form into a tropical storm or anything, but it's just going to be adding to those rainfall totals, especially along the coast, and this will eventually press inward. But yeah, it can dump some very heavy rain and upwards to 3 inches per hour rainfall rates. They're having to deal with that this morning with that slow-moving tropical wave. So as we expand the view and look at the big picture on where the rain prospects are going to be throughout the day, we can see that tropical disturbance. This pushes inland. You have what they call easterly flow. That'll spread the precipitation chances along into the southeast, getting into sporadic parts of Oklahoma into North Texas. A lot of these areas have a lot of wet soil, higher dew point. So all it takes is some instability aloft to get those little, you know, sporadic isolated thunderstorms. And if they do pop up, these could have some damaging winds associated with them, with a lot of the heat content they're going to be dealing with in the upper atmosphere. But there's that boundary up to the north. There's we have that'll kick off another round of showers and some storms, and those could be severe in parts of the upper plains today. But we also have the active monsoon. You get a little reprieve down here into the Phoenix area. Man, they've been taking advantage of that. In fact, 3 days in a row, they hit below 85 degrees, first time ever since they recorded stats 1896. The high was 83, 83, and then 81 yesterday. The average high is 106, guys. I mean, that is just incredible stuff. And they're getting some, you know, welcome rain, but unfortunately, some of the flooding rain they're having to deal with. But a lot of that precipitation has pushed off into Southern California today. That's where the flash flood watches take place, and that's where they're seeing some of that heavier rain this morning. So as we look at the Storm Prediction Center, that's that highlighted threat along that boundary. Some of these could turn severe in places like Duluth into St. Cloud, getting in around to Superior, Wisconsin here. Some of those could be, again, the main culprit from these storms, damaging winds, and they have some large hail associated with them with that cold core loft. I showed you the cold air filtering down from the north. A lot of that's going to get mixed up in the upper atmosphere, and that's going to be the indication where you could see some of those who produce some larger hailstones later on this afternoon with those stronger storms. The tornado threat is very low with this system, but you can't be ruled out and that part of the country, as these will continue pressing southeast as we go into the afternoon hours, into the evening hours. And there's the overall setup for Tuesday. You can see that boundary, that low pressure, more or less pushes inland, just around, in and around north of Florida here, southeastern parts of Georgia. That'll keep the rain chances alive and well, as that you'll have that first boundary, and then you have that second boundary, and right along that boundary, that's where the instability is going to be taking place, and that's where some of the severe weather is going to be taking place as well, as the active monsoon will continue to press. Now the storms will be out of LA and continue to press further north into northern Nevada, southern Oregon, getting into even parts of Idaho might start seeing some of those rain as that monsoon will press further northward as we go through with that Tuesday. There's your storm threat for that Tuesday. Those areas will jump a little bit further down to the south. Now we're getting impacted in parts of Minneapolis, getting into the Bloomington area, Plymouth area. Those areas could be under the gun for that severe weather. Again, some, damaging winds, some of that large hail to be contend with in that neck of the woods, and that will spread eastward as we go through time, eventually impacting the Milwaukee area and to Grand Rapids. And then even down to the south into Sioux Falls, South Dakota as well. So as we move forward to Wednesday, that July 28th timeframe, there's that boundary. So that will continue to remain active with that stronger storms. That easterly flow will continue to remain active as well. That will continue trying to press a little bit further off into the east, into LA, and Louisiana here, into Arkansas. Some of that precipitation could spread as far, to into the Dallas-Fort Worth area. These are just isolated chances. These are like 10-20%, right? I mean, it's going to be drying out in this region as the ridge is going to be dominating. It's just this ridge kind of backs up a little bit by the time we get to Wednesday, could actually spread that easterly flow a little bit further off into in North Texas to could, dump, drop the triple digits out of that area. But along that boundary where that high pressure is going to be dominant, you got that sinking ridge, and then you have that flow down here off the eastern Pacific. That's going to keep the monsoon alive and well for a good chunk of next week as well. Not as strong, not as nearly as active what you've been dealing with, but still around and still adding to those rainfall totals. So as we go through that Wednesday, there's your storm threat. We'll continue traversing right across that boundary. So you have that cooler air filtering in. That's going to be the mix. That's going to be bringing your severe weather in and around the Minneapolis area. We'll dive into the Milwaukee area with those stronger storms. And then it will eventually spread into Chicago, get it into Pittsburgh with some of that stronger indications traversing right along that boundary. And then down to the southeast, down to the south in the central part of the U.S. under that, in that white area, that's going to be the dominating ridge. under that high pressure, and that's going to be that sinking air. You're not going to be able to see any rain chances there, and you can definitely see kind of the donut not happening. It's just it swings around that ridge of high pressure. There's that tropical disturbance will probably fade, but keeping the rain chances alive, taking advantage of the warmer Gulf waters. As we heat up in the afternoon, you get these sea breeze activity along the coastal communities in and around the Florida area. And then there's the active monsoon, continues to remain active in the Four Corners regions. That will spread around the ridge of high pressure. So you see the white here, that's where the ridge is going to be dominating. So it's more or less going to be spreading around it. And there's that boundary that's going to be alive and well as we get into the day on that Thursday timeframe in and around the Mid-Atlantic states as we go through then. But look at the temperatures. I mean, as there's that first boundary, we'll drop temperatures into the 70s for parts of Wisconsin, Michigan, the upper Northeast, and into the New England areas. Even in the Maine, we'll drop into the 70s and got a much reinforcing shot as we go into early next week, which I'll highlight at the end of the video. But there's that triple digits for much of the central U.S. into the Dallas-Fort Worth area under that ridge of high pressure. Where you see these lower temperatures, that's where the rain's going to be falling. That's where the active monsoon's going to be. But then, you know, by that Friday time frame, there's the rain prospects as we get into that time frame. Again, same areas, easterly flow, where that boundary is in the Mid-Atlantic states, and then you have the active monsoon will continue to remain active. But the smoke will remain active. That has not gone away. I mean, the wildfires has not gone away at all, where it's been dominant for the ridge of high pressure. A lot of people have been asking about the smoke. So here's where the smoke could be by the time we get into that Friday timeframe still. And around these areas, you have the wildfires and the smoke, and it gets caught up in the jet stream. And a lot of the northern regions will experience some of that smoke, and it'll eventually actually spread into parts of the eastern U.S. as well. And they've been dealing with that. And it's probably going to be continuing to happen probably at least through the middle of August. I don't really see that subsiding at all with this dominant ridge and unfortunately all the dynamics that are happening up here. So they're still going to be dealing with those wildfires for several more weeks to come. But there's your high temperatures as we get into that Friday time frame. Again, under that ridge of high pressure, we got in and around near triple digits. But man, the standout here is the Northeast. I mean, some of these even drop into in the 60s for high temperatures. Man, we're talking, that's going to be feeling really nice as we go towards the end of July, especially up into the New England states. And then, yeah, there's the setup for that. For Saturday as we start August, and still we have that boundary, we have the instability with that low pressure just kind of hanging around here into the southeast, into Mississippi and Alabama, getting, you know, parts of Georgia again, into Florida with some of those heavier rains. The active monsoon continues to remain alive, and now we have a reinforcing shot of colder air that's going to be penetrating the Northeast again, and then that'll swing into the Ohio Valley as we get into the first couple of days of August. So there's your temperatures to end July on the 31st. Again, triple digits for much of the central U.S. under that dominating ridge. We remain cooler up here to the Northeast into New England. And as we look at the rainfall prospects for that Saturday time frame, August the 1st, kind of the same deal, guys. I mean, this stays alive and well, pretty active down here with this disturbance, the active monsoon, and then we have these boundaries that swing up that are going to be staying up to the northeast. And there's your high temperatures for that Sunday time frame. Again, the cooler conditions remain pretty much right here along this edge from Minnesota to Wisconsin to Michigan here, all the Northeast. That'll eventually start to creep down into the Ohio Valley, where you just heat up more into the around the Dallas-Fort Worth area, where you dry. And as that soil starts to dry out there, you're going to be able to heat up, and probably your highest temperatures of the year are going to be coming up on August 1st by the time we get into that Sunday, August 1st time frame for Dallas. But man, next week, that cold front means business. I mean, I showed you that 34 just north of Winnipeg, and that's going to bring some of that cooler air with the Arctic Oscillation going negative, the Eastern Pacific Oscillation going negative. And that's going to bring some cooler, almost fall-like air for that neck of the woods with those 10 to 15 degrees below average temperatures. That's going to be a welcome relief of the heat. And man, if you look at kind of zoom into that area for the Northeast, by the time we get into that Tuesday, August 3rd time frame, these are morning lows. We're talking widespread 50s and much of Minnesota, up here in Wisconsin, into Michigan, much of Indiana, Ohio, West Virginia, Pennsylvania, New York, all the New England states here into Maine. Yeah, 50s or low temperatures. That's going to feel really nice. And it really doesn't rebound all that much. I mean, a lot of 60s showing up on the map for that Tuesday time frame. And some could even actually get out of the 50s. So this is going to be some very almost not chilly, but still, yeah, from feeling really nice. And some of these areas in Maine, I'm hearing reports already that some of the leaves are already starting to change colors as the Mother Nature's really given a shot of cooler air and trying to say, hey, you know, we're still in summer, guys. We're still in summer, but yeah, this is not going to feel like summer coming up early next week into the Northeast. But there's your rain prospects over the next 7 to 10 days, where that dominating ridge is going to be much over Texas. It's going to be pretty dry in Texas, where that active monsoon flow is. It's going to continue to remain the higher rain chances in and around the Four Quarters regions. That'll actually spread into parts of Idaho, getting into Wyoming here. A lot of rain coming up for even Colorado as well. But that's a welcome sight to see in Southern California, getting into Nevada, and even parts of Oregon is going to get into the action with some of that heavier rain as we go throughout the week. Where that disturbance is going to be along the coast, that's where the heaviest rain's going to fall. And then where those boundaries with that first boundary, and then you have that second boundary compounding, will keep the active flow alive for the northern interiors and the northeast regions for that neck of the woods. So, hey, I appreciate you guys watching. Do like this video and definitely leave your comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel to catch the latest update, where I protect you before and after the storm.